Sort by newest. Wow, there's 5 million comments. What were you doing 10 years ago? Listening to Gangnam Style? Let's get the other chat on. Small chat. Wow. 9 years ago, this guy was in 2022. Hello, 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 hello. Who is here after YouTube feature? It 1B views. In a few more hours, this masterpiece will turn 10 years old. Let's set a world record together and get the most like comment on YouTube. Right, bro. I'll help. I will help. We're off to a good start. We're off to a good start. Happy 10-year anniversary to this classic. Happy 1 billion. Isn't it way more than 1 billion views? It's 4 billion, right? This thing's fucking massive. It's almost as big as the Papathon album, really, when you think about it. This is Indian song old. What? What does that mean? What does that mean? What does that mean? Indian songs are 10 years old? What does that mean? Let's set a world record together and get the most like comment on YouTube. This guy's farther ahead. This guy's at six. I hope you are too. Let's see. Who else remember the time when YouTube was only parodies of this song? Someone posting the lyrics? 20 minutes ago, someone thought it was useful to type up the lyrics. It's been 10 years. I'm quite certain people can find the lyrics. That's crazy. I need to drop a comment. Still watching in 2022. This was real music. Take me back. Perfect. Perfect, dude. I always wondered why people do this. Why people go to a 4 billion view video and comment anything. It's just shouting into the void. But that was really satisfying. I gotta do what they all do and like my own comment. It's what every fuck does in the YouTube comments with a stupid comment, they like their own. It's always one like. Yeah, I know who that like is, dude. You're not, it's not a fucking social movement. It's you liked your own. Yogi Yugi, thank you for the prime. Your prime means so much to me. Getting $2.50 from Jeff Bezos makes my year. For you to give him a couple $100 a year to get access to Prime, and then he can subsidize a little bit of that towards his growing but still money losing Twitch business to help give it some sort of competitive advantage over YouTube by retaining streamers for $2.50. Thank you for the Prime. Oh my God, dude. I am actually fucking blowing up. This is bigger than my fucking YouTube videos. 77 replies. Holy shit, dude. I'm actually gonna give up. I'm done with fucking making my own content. Making my own content is cringe and requires effort and planning and thought. What I'm gonna do is become a full-time YouTube commenter. That seems way more fun. That seems way cooler. Let's see. Let's go to here, I got an idea. Ludwig. Let's go to my boy Ludwig's latest video. How Mr. Beast embarrassed me in front of 20,000 people. 11 on Trending Over Gaming. Bad vid. Doing my part. Doing my part. Man, being too common rules. Rules, dude. Rules. Haven't even watched it. The crazy thing is I haven't even watched it. I'm 8 seconds in. Haven't even watched it, but I think my opinion deserves to be known. I think my opinion deserves to be known. Let's go to Stance. Stance. I'm getting fucking Entourage moments. Well, okay, wait, I gotta pause. Before I continue down this YouTube commenter path, I have to let you guys know some bad news. I'm backsliding. I am backsliding into my 20-year-old self back in the fucking third century. I am turning back into a Grussler. I am turning back into a Grussler, dude. I am literally, you know what? Capitalism is not that bad. You know what? Capitalism? Kind of chill. I'm literally turning back into a Grussler. I don't know what happened. When I was on my Game of Thrones shit, it was all good. But then I got auto-recommended a fucking Entourage episode on HBO Max. And I watched it, and I'm fucking, it's like I'm 20 again. I'm grinding. I've been grinding. I've been walking and talking on the phone today. Just trying to wheel and deal. I don't know what the fuck's going on. It was all good just a week ago. I like how 20 is super long ago for you. It's 10 years. Didn't you mention that your recommendations are only Game of Thrones and the alt-right pipeline? That's what it was. But then I picked Game of Thrones. But now I'm going to get fucking, like, I'm getting, like, Ari Gold best moments. Are you still doing push-ups now that Ari's back? Yeah, I am. I did different exercises today, but I did exercise. When is the Fortnite stream? I'm not doing one. I told my dad that I was a Sigma, and he told me that he had never heard of it. Omega lol, he's such a virgin. Yeah, you got him. You owned him, dude. You truly owned him. There's so much wrong with that, but we don't need to. Wait, I was going to YouTube comment on Stan's account. Yeah, I'm going to do other things YouTube commenters do. I'm going to go to Stan's account. I'm going to go to this company banned gay horses. Okay, and then I'm going to say, love this video. Brings me such a smile. Thanks again for always making great content that warms my heart when I'm going through a really tough time. And then, okay, I watched it. And there we go. Algorithm tricked. Is Fall Guys back? Feek Atrioc. Where else can I? Bro. fooled the algo? Yeah, I definitely fooled it. Coney thumbnail? Oh, my God. Have you guys seen this? Bro, just while we're on the YouTube subject. Look at this. 3 days straight, this motherfucker has been using not only my thumbnail pose, but my literal hand. Legitimately, that is not his hand. That is my watch and my hand photoshopped out. I also think he fucking photoshopped in my teeth. By the way, he told me that they're all like 4 out of 10, 2 out of 10. One, like they're all doing well. They're all doing well. So there's, I've said, dude. He said the worst one of his last 6 is this one. What's the odd man out here, dude? What's the odd man? Where's the hand in this one? I will subscribe to Coney, actually. I love Coney. Am I subbed to Afghans? Oh, I have to undo that. I actually have watched Afghans content. Look at this. I mean, bad retention. I don't know why you bored me to death right here, Afghans, but this one was good. I liked the guessing rent video. I would have thought that did better. I don't know. Maybe the thumbnail or something, because I thought it was really funny. I thought you did a great job. I like my videos sopping wet. Yeah, me too. Hey, Atrioc, why did the photograph go to prison? Because it murdered my entire family. Bro, that is such a... That's like a Tumblr 2009 iFunny type fucking joke, dude. That... No, that's not an I can't moment. I guess it is an I can't moment. Actually, I can't is what you use for a fucking iFunny type thing. So yeah, it actually is. It's actually classic. This chat got me giggling for real, for real. Yeah, you guys don't miss. You guys don't miss. Hey, Big A, did you see Elon Musk's dad? What do you think? What do you fucking think? Every single fucking day this whole week, I've been roasting Elon Musk, but I just missed it. I just missed the brand new story that Elon Musk's dad is basically a fucking pedophile, dude. He's absolutely a groomer. Elon Musk's dad is having kids with basically his stepdaughter. Actually, legitimately his stepdaughter, right? I think he legitimately, it's not even like basic, I think it legitimately was his stepdaughter. Yeah, Elon Musk's father has another kid that he didn't tell anybody about. He raised a stepdaughter from 4 years old and then had a kid with her. Classic. Classic, dude. Classic Musk family situation. I thought I had a fucking post on it. But anyway, yeah, I did notice it. That didn't slip my mind. I've been reading everything about... I mean, listen, it actually just came up because I was reading about... Elon Musk's dad, age 76... confirms secret second child with his stepdaughter. What a ghoul, dude. What an absolute ghoul of a man. I think you have a chance in the YouTube comment game. Yeah, what else could I comment on? Yeah, it's incredibly gross. I mean, I don't know. There's no, like, deep fucking cut here. But it's just weird, right? It's just weird. She's an executive at Tesla? No, really? No. Come on, dude. What is this fucking thing? Why do they all have to be not only... Why? It was already weird. Now it's an employee thing, too? Wait, I have to confirm that. Was she actually an executive at Tesla? Wow, what the hell? What the hell? Okay, is she an executive at Tesla? That's what I want to know. Does she work at Tesla? I need to know. Tesla. I don't see anything for that. I'm not sure that you are correct. I'm not sure that you're correct. I don't think it's true. Oh, she is a Tesla exec. Wait. Yeah, Elon had twins with a Neuralink executive. Yeah, yeah. But you have to get them. Listen, this is very common. Have you ever owned three companies and had 10 kids, some of which are from executives at your companies, but also your father had a secret kid with an executive at your company? Like, we've all been there, dude. Let's not, hey, Judge not, lest ye be judged. You know what I'm saying? Those in glass houses cannot throw stones. And if you guys are all in a similar situation, let's not call it weird. When he's in, that happens. Okay, that's normal family dynamics. Each kid will get a company. He's going to own 10 companies. No, because they multiply. Dude. Every company he gets, he's going to have a new kid. But I don't know. There's not too much more to say. Except that it's really weird. just a weird thing to come out. Definitely probably not the time. I got to say, if I'm Elon Musk's PR guy, it's been a rough couple weeks. And you don't want to wake up and get that phone call. That's not on your bingo board for fires you wanted to put out that day. You're kind of just hoping. You know, I just feel bad for that guy's job. That's a tough call to get. Did you see Martin Shkreli streaming on Twitch today? Yeah, I'm in my Grussel mode, dude. Of course I did. I tuned in frame one to give him a tier 3 sub and said, give me knowledge, sir. I'm part of the Shkreli squad. No, I didn't see it. What did he do? I thought he has been completely off of Twitch since he went to jail and then got out. I have not seen Andrew Tate's debate with XQC. I'm sure it's funny. Maybe I'll check out clips or something, but I haven't seen it. Again, most of the stuff that happens during the workday, I miss out. He played the unreleased Wu-Tang? Did he actually? No way he would do that. There's no way. That guy's way too greedy to just play the unreleased Wu-Tang for free. He did? So it's available now? People ripped it and I can listen to the new Wu-Tang? Is there a video? Can't be that good, right? I feel like if you made an actual classic album, you're not going to sell one of one. Yeah, I think if you make a mid album with Wu-Tang, then you're like, okay, then this is a good.
think about strangling me. What the fuck? Oh god.
Bro, this actually goes for a while. Anyway, he ends up saying the word that comes to mind is embarrassing. I'm embarrassed. I'm embarrassed for him. which is funny. Which is funny. a different Anthony Fantano. Yeah, Logic. That would be the funniest tweet. If Logic tweeted, it's about a different Fantano, you arrogant fuck. That would actually bring him back to the GOAT status. And I actually think his music's amazing again. That would actually be the funniest fucking tweet I could ever imagine. Did you listen to the album? I actually have not listened to it, but I did listen to this song, and I thought it was cringe. Well, I mean, I've liked some Logic songs over the years. I'm not going to say I'm not. I mean, listen, I'm a white fan of rap. They put it in my playlist on purpose, dude. If I try to fucking take them out, Spotify goes, we know you. We know you have Hamilton on your fucking list, dude. And they put Logic back in. I can't fucking escape it. So, yeah, I get a couple. But I'm not a big Logic fan, if I'm being honest. I'm not a big Logic fan. Is your Fantano skit on the album? He's on the album? That's wild. Is the album actually good? I'll check it out. I will check it out. And I'll keep an open mind, because I've liked some stuff for sure. Hamilton self-report. I fucking love Hamilton. I won't apologize for it. I won't apologize for it, dude. Lin-Manuel Miranda type wealthy liberals stole Hamilton. They stole it, and now it's not cool to like it. Okay? And it's really talented. I'll stand on this hill. It's really talented, dude. Didn't Lin-Manuel Miranda write it? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, but I just mean, like, you know, there's this whole, like, how to describe it. It's like this, this movement of people that have a lot to say but do nothing and never talk about, like, anything related to income inequality, really. You know, which is, like, the real actual problem and everything. Yeah, neoliberalism, basically, but it's like a certain, I don't even know how to describe it. It's like, you know, if, like, they were mad at Trump, they would write slam poetry or something. Do you know what I'm saying? It's like this, it was really active around 2016. And, you know, it's like a complete joke of a movement that does not get anything done, but it, like, is really righteous anger. And that group loves Hamilton, and since then it has made Hamilton ever cornier. But listen, I like it, and I liked it at the time, and I still like it, and I'm not gonna apologize for it, because it's fun. And also, just the fact that it exists got me to read a fuck ton. I actually read so much about what I didn't know about the Revolutionary War, and about how, you know, the first Bank of America was founded, and I learned a lot. It started my learning journey. So, it's also a musical, which is automatically bad. Plus, part two, you guys are not hearing. If I didn't deeply understand Hamilton, I wouldn't be able to enjoy the lore of the Dream SMP, which is literally ripped one for one almost all the time from Hamilton. In case you guys didn't figure it out, All they did was get a bunch of young British children that watched Hamilton and just did it in Minecraft. You guys understand? Did anyone figure that out? That's what they did. Everything they did was inspired by recently watching Hamilton. They literally just say the lyrics at some points. How do you know so much about Dream SMP? All right, listen, I stay active in the community, Aspect Core. I don't like your line of questioning. I don't like where your line of questioning is going. Connor is Hamilton. Cringe TikTok regarding what you're talking about? Let me see. I would love to see what you're talking about. Oh my God, dude, this is exactly
land of the free, home of the brave, land of the AR-15, home of kids in the grave. I've struggled to find the words, keep the disposition sunny. I'm always trying to turn the unfunny things funny, but laughing feels wrong. Hypocrisy's rife, I gotta say something, cause you're all pro-life unless it's taken by a gunman. 19 more tiny heartbeats stopped in the realm of...
Mitch McConnell with a single tear watching this. I'm gonna change my ways. I'm going to change. You know what, NRA? Take your money back. This kind of shit is... Who is going to be moved? Anyone watching musical talk is already on your side, man. But this is also the guy that had... Oh, I feel so bad for this guy. Is it still up? This thing. Oh my God. This thing.
I want to be the next SNL cast member, and here's why I should be a contender. Hi, Lorne Michaels, I'm Jake Novak, and I know that you're feeling the heat because your roster lost Kate, Kyle, 80, and Pete. That means you got an open seat, and I feel I ought to be filling it because when it comes to...
you imagine Pete Davidson leaves, and you're like, yeah, let's get this guy. Let's get Jake Novak.
Comedy songs, I kind of been killing it. See weekly music videos, I'm a jam, bruh. I'm a rapid rhyming hammy nerd like Lin-Manuel Miranda mixed with Sammy Berg. But haven't you heard, I'm more than a rapper. I'm an actor too, so here's a couple of nice guys getting their jackets.
After you. After you. After you.
After you.
After you.
After you've seen that scene, I mean, I'm in, right? But I've been sitting on the ringer. In addition to the spitting, I'm a hell of a singer. I could be bouncing out on Broadway, but I'm running for 30 Rock, so I can handle...
I know the words.
Not literally. Obviously, I really want to give you the next big thing. Oh, God.
Dear Mr. Michaels, won't you give me a chance? My melodies will make the people laugh while they dance.
All right, I'll perform, man. I'll sweep the stage. But whenever it is, I'm ready to do it in Studio 8H. What do you say? Did I dive or get you to bite? Maybe we could try it live on a Saturday night. So check my feed. You'll agree where I should be in September. Right with Colin Keane and Chloe Bowen as an SNL cast member.
Woo!
I want to be the next SNL cast.
Woo! I'm sure Lorne Michaels is going to pick you up right away. Anyway, TikTok fucking roasted the guy.
Listen, I want to be the next SNL cast member. And here's... I want to be the...
Hold up. Let me see if I can... By the way... So, if you guys don't know, in the video... He says, I make weekly music videos. And he had done that up until that point. And then the entire internet roasted that video. Like, it's his most viewed video of all time. Everyone roasted it so hard, he has been dark for 17 days. He has not posted a single word. I feel kind of bad. Because at the end of the day, you shoot your shot. It's cringe. But here's what I think. Internet loves a comeback story. He makes one more, a little bit self-aware, perhaps. Who knows? Who knows? I don't think he's getting the 30 Rock. I don't think he's getting SNL. But he goes from zero views to starting to get some views. Nah, fuck that. It wasn't good, and he needs to know it wasn't good. Who hurt you, man? Who hurt you? Who hurt you? A lot of things aren't good, man. A lot of things aren't good. You gotta go. There's 4 billion TikToks uploaded every day. You got to be the one to get out there and let them know which ones are good or not. Some shit my dad would say. Yeah, dude, get Elon back on SNL with this guy. That's the fucking dream. Where is this?
1,200 auditions and not a single ounce of talent. Who's our last guy? Jake Novak?
Hi, Jake Novak? Thanks for coming in. What are you doing for us? An original? Great. Yeah, whenever you're ready.
I want to be the next SNL cast member, and here's why I should be a contender. Hi, Lorne Michaels, I'm Jake Novak, and I know that you're feeling the heat because your roster lost Kate, Kyle, 80 MP. That means you got an open seat, and I feel loud to be filling it, because when it comes to comedy songs, I kind of been killing it. See, weekly music videos, I'm a jam, bruh. I'm a rapid rhyming hammy nerd like Lin-Manuel Miranda mixed with Sammy Berg. But haven't you heard? I'm more than a rapper. I'm an actor, too, so here's a couple of nice guys getting their jackets.
After you. After you. After you. After you. After you!
After you've seen that scene, I mean, I'm it, right? But I've been sitting on the ringer. In addition to the spitting, I'm a hell of a singer. I could be bouncing out on Broadway.
Yes!
1,200 auditions and not a...
That's fucking hilarious. Is this what Jack Harlow sounds like to black people?
I want to be the next SNL cast member, and here's why I should be a contender. Hi, Lorne Michaels, I'm Jake Novak, and I know that you're feeling...
That's funny.
Wow, we're really coming up empty. Almost 100 auditions and we got nothing.
That's probably the same.
You think the studio would give us maybe...
I think it's the same one. Same joke. Don't steal it. Jake Novak's getting too much hate. We're going
to
fix his song.
I'm going to be the first to say it. It's not true. I'm not the first. Jake Novak's getting too much hate, so we're going to fix his song.
I want to be the next SNL.
Bought a fucking sound player.
But I'm sitting on the ring. In addition to the spin, I'm not the singer. I'm gonna be the next SNL cast member. I wanna be the next SNL cast member. I wanna be the next SNL cast member. I wanna be the next SNL cast member.
I'm gonna be the first to say it's not true. I'm not the first.
You made it work. I think he was trying to take the heat. I think he was trying to jump on the grenade. It was too late, unfortunately. But what a hero. My God, he found a way to make it worse. He was like, internet, wait! It's not as bad as you think. But by the way, imagine him, at least he submitted a coherent song that had, if he submitted your thing, it doesn't make any fucking sense. What is this? Yeah, that's the Yonda Hitchcock freestyle. Yeah, I already found it. I found it. Once I know his name, I know what it is. New Jake Novak video. What is this? This is DaBaby doesn't
need auto-tune. Good morning, USA.
This is one of the worst things I've ever seen, and I'm going to ban you. Obviously. Obviously. And also, you've been banned before. The lack of self-awareness and self-embarrassment is honestly commendable. Yeah, I mean, it is truly someone with no self-awareness and no shame. So you'll probably end up being a huge TikToker. If I'm being honest about Mr. Jake Novak, he'll probably end up being a huge TikToker. You give him enough time. Or an Atrioc leech. Shit's legit going to be in my head for the next few days. What do you mean? It's going to be in your head? You're going to be humming along? after you, at the fucking gym? It's not catchy. He's corny enough to cut it at SNL. Man, I think dropping Pete Davidson for that guy is a crazy, crazy take. But SNL has not been relevant in a while. So, yeah, I'm not saying he's going to be fucking out of his element there, but I think when you think about who he's trying to recreate, which is Andy Samberg, who I think was pretty ahead of his time, the Lonely Island guys, I think they were actually super ahead of their time for online comedy sketches. And SNL was still cutting edge when they did it. And they did great stuff. This guy's not Andy Samberg in any sense of his animation. Stretch of his imagination. You know what, dude? What's the fucking banger? Is the opening to the, this song. This song is stuck in my head for real still.
Guys, Michael Bolton is here.
Oh, great! Send him in.
Hey guys.
Hey.
How's it going?
I'm really sorry I'm late. I just got caught up watching the Pirates of the Caribbean marathon. Have you seen those things?
Oh yeah, yeah. Those are great.
Well, I listened to your track. It's an actual banger, dude. And I wrote you this big, sexy hook. I think you're gonna really dig.
Oh wow, that's great. You want to just lay it down,
boys? Let's get to it. To it. To it.
This went hard. This went hard back in the day. Was it censored? Oh my god. They censored it? Maybe that's a 2012 thing. Bro, my 17-year-old self is pogging. Yeah. Yeah. It banged. Dick in the box. Banged. Jizz in my pants. Who could forget? Kendrick verse on YOLO. I don't even remember it, but I think it was good. The Natalie Portman Lonely Island video. I mean, the Natalie Portman rap. Was that Lonely Island? I don't even remember. But yeah, that was funny. Way back. Video essay about the Lonely Island? I don't know about a video essay. It's good, right? We like it. How about we say that? Natalie Portman one's crazy. Please finish the song. You guys are acting like I fucking gave you a poison with no antidote. Open a fucking tab and watch it if you want to. You're like, dude, this one guy, the same guy keeps fucking saying it over and over. Please, please. Oh my God, please. Bro, fucking watch it yourself, little bitch. Do you think you'll play the... Yeah, I'm going to play Ori games. Actually, my plan today was to play more Elden Ring. I think I'm nearing the end. And I think what I'd like to do is beat Elden Ring as soon as possible so that I can play Ori. But I'm not going to play both. To be clear, I will not play the first Ori game. I'm going to watch a video explaining it so we can all catch up together. And then I'm going to play the next one. That's what I'm going to do. Because I know that if I create a task that is too large, it'll take me, I'll keep doing one stream a week or whatever. It'll take forever. So I'm going to just focus in. I'm going to do tight. And I've heard the first one, while, you know, good, is not nearly as good as the second one. From people I trust. So I'll just jump in, you know? Like, why do you need to watch... God damn it. Okay. It got stuck. My headphones got stuck. My first playthrough of Ori 1 was about 3 hours. Oh, really? It's that fast? Insane. But I don't think I'll just skip it. Raycons wouldn't get stuck. So fucking true. So fucking true. Fall Guys came out with a real gamer challenge gauntlet. Wait, really? What does that mean? I've been cracked at Fall Guys lately. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. A gamer challenge gauntlet? HR, I just wanted to ask, are you having a poggers day? I wouldn't describe it as such, but I'm having a good day. I would use the word good. because I'm a functioning adult. I don't think I'd say
poggers.
Thoughts on the new PlayStation reward system? Do you want me to just fucking take all my wins and fails and give them out early from Marketing Monday? No. I have to save that shit. So I have a full stream. I said poggers at work a few days ago. What was the context? Turtle, what was the context to you saying poggers at work? Drake was arrested in Sweden? Drake arrested? Wait, I googled Drake arrested. I don't see anything about Drake, but Drake Bell was arrested on child endangerment. Wait, was he? Drake Bell pleaded guilty to felony attempted child endangerment? Look at this. Still goes hard, I gotta say. Well, we're jailing this guy? Child endangerment? What is that? What, you drove fast with a car in the with a kid in the passenger seat? What is that? What, like what? What was the what does that mean, endangerment? Oh, he groomed a fan. Okay, that's all right, the song doesn't go that hard. I was gonna give him a pass if he just drove fast. You know what I'm saying? Like if a kid was didn't have a seatbelt on or something, I was gonna be like, all right, come on now. But unfortunate. I didn't read the article, no. I did. Hoodat, thank you for the raid. I haven't heard from Hoodat in a minute. I was talking with Stance. It's just so crazy to me, I think. A couple things are crazy. It's the fact that Hoodat and Neg and that whole group live together. Because Hoodat made a D's Nuts joke one time in 2020 is crazy. Like that's a wild cosmic butterfly effect of the world. That's wild. But I was also thinking, I'm going to be hanging out with Linkus really soon, like in person. And we're just like good friends. Like I really like Linkus. I just like chat with him. I like talking to him. And it's like that only happened because in a fucking Minecraft speedrun pro-am, I got randomly selected when the thing shot out the fucking diamond or whatever. Like we jumped on the pad and it shot out a random pairing and I got Linkus in that Minecraft pro-am. And otherwise I would never have ever talked to him again. Like we never would have hung out. It's so wild that my world is altered because of that one thing happening. It's just weird. And I just remember, it's so funny because both me and Linkus were thinking when the pairings were being picked, like that's the one guy I don't know. I hope I don't get him. Like I was like, I hope I don't get, who the fuck's Linkus? Don't get me. I hope I get Simply, dude. I hope I get. And he was like, who's Atrioc? I hope I don't get him. And like we got each other, and we ended up being good friends. Like it's just wild. It's just fucking crazy. Yeah, I think Linkus and Maisie, his girlfriend, they're both great people. I like them a lot. I think they're just good. And now they live in California, so. Coulda had me. Fail. hey, how's the video doing? I'm gonna ban Vail if it's not, if it's below 5 out of 10, Vail, you're banned. You wasted my time. Okay, we're gonna find out. Checking. Ooh. Ooh. Vail, I'm sorry to do this to you. But you survived! You survived! Woo! 35K views in like the first hour. Let's go 4 out of 10. It's gonna take some time. Do you guys know the first video I ever had that hit 100,000 views in a day was this one? The Hunt for the Golden Glizzy. And it was with S3K. It was me and S3K playing Fall Guys. Shocking. I'm shocked this was the one, but it was. That vid is the greatest of all. How come every time I show a single vid from my channel, everyone's like, that was my favorite? And like, I haven't showed any of the classic vids. I've only shown like the fucking freestyle one or the Hunt for the Golden Glizzy. And everyone's there's one person like, man, you really should try to get back to that. Get back to what? Hunting for the Golden Glizzy? It's a one-time thing. They're all one-off vids. Ooh, Maya's going. Wait, let me check on my dog. Let me check on my dog, dude. My dog barking. My pup woofing.
Set up, unfortunately.
Yes, yeah, we used to have the old place.
I'm sorry. Anyway, I'm still alive, but I was supposed to have
SMS. Oh, yeah, it looked like, yeah. We were meant at AX.
I'm going to show the string to the Yule. At the bottom. What a sweet pooch! You are the sweetest pup in the world, and everybody knows it. Everybody. You're so sweet, and you get scared of everything. That's your whole shtick. Okay. Yeah, I'll let you go. She might start murdering again. We got a guest here, so. She does not look depressed, obviously. I think you guys are depressed, because if you're stealing slime jokes, you're in a bad spot. Atrioc, do cat and dog like each other? Hold up. Do I got a photo for you? May champs. Wait a minute. Hold. Check this out, you fucks. Look at this. Oh, that's not a good photo. Wait. There's got to be a better photo than that. Hey, look at this one. It's a cat in a box! Ari made this little box out of paper, and then the cat just fucking took an instant nap in it. What else? Wait. Oh, yeah, here it is. I found it. Look, they're friends. They're finally taking naps together. Maya used to be a bit of a diva about it, but now they're twins. It's actually the most goated thing in the world when I finish work and I lay down on the couch and they both fucking lay down on me. It is the goat feeling. It's like, this is cool. This is even better than fucking beating a 12-year-old in Fall Guys. Barely, but it is. Better than sex? I don't know. I never had it. Never had sex, but I can tell you I played a lot of Fall Guys. Let me check on this show selector. So what are we talking about for... You said there was some amazing gamer mode. And I don't see it. None of these are particularly gamer modes. Blast Ball Trials is not gamer mode. Ski Fall is not even a fucking great game. What? What is... There's no... Where's this gamer mode you talked about? I think you lied to me. Straight up. I think I got liared. One game for the fans. Host. Right now. Get in. Boot up Fall Guys. 6QQFC. One game for the fans. Uh-oh. Who's getting in? 6QQFC. It's all on the line. This is where the goats are created. Who's in? Mix and match. We're just doing a straight up solo shoot, actually. We're doing a straight up solo shoot. 6QQFC. If you download it now, do you think you'll make it? Nope, you won't. I'm only doing one. We're literally only doing one. Even if I die first round, I'm only doing one. This is it. This is your one chance. Update. Winner gets a Ferrari. That's the facts. Winner of this match gets a Ferrari. Do you guys know that? You guys know that the first big esports prize in history was a Ferrari? John Carmack, the creator of Quake and Doom. I think it was a Quake tournament. It was the first real big multiplayer FPS tournament. A player named Dennis Fong, a.k.a. Thresh, won it and won John Carmack's Ferrari. And then spent like 8 years touring the country doing interviews about how he was like a gamer that won a Ferrari. And then I think he ended up making something really... Bro, I think Thresh like invented something big. I don't remember what it was. He invented Tesla. Oh, we're starting. Let me see. Dennis Thresh Fong. He invented X-Fire. Oh. X-Fire was an instant messenger and social networking site for gamers, which sounds stupid because we've never heard of it, but he sold it for $102 million to Viacom. So, who's laughing now? Holy shit, dude. Very early Discord? Yes, sir. It's funny how many bad acquisitions there have been. People have made so much money selling dog shit products to companies that don't know what they do with all their money. Easy clap bag alert? Yeah, exactly. So he's kind of chilling. Oh, back row? Restart. Everybody wait. I'm the streamer. Let me go to the front. Wow. I'm really in the back. This is kind of fucked, actually. This doesn't feel fair. Dude, I'm so far in the fucking back. Okay. Starting to get some distance. Starting to get some distance. Oh, shit. Aye. Wait. Ah! Yeet! Oh, yeah, I'm goated. Oh, yeah, you're talking to the goat. Dude, you're talking to the ghost. Almost better than the goat. Ba-ding! I have like 20 hours of Battlefield 1942 videos with that one dude. I feel like we have just stopped. What? Oh. Yeah. I mean, it's like such nostalgia bait, but everyone does that post where it's like, you know, when you log on to an old game and see all those friends you made on the friends list that are like last online 8 years ago or whatever. You've never spoken to them since, but you had great times. It's classic nostalgia bait, dude. It's, you know, it's, that's not really a thing that happens as much now, though, right? I feel like if you make a friend online, you're getting into Discords and you have like that connection outside of the game. Like if you move to a different game, it's fine. But, you know, the farther back you go, the more you just like make a friend through an online friends list in a game and you'd never, ever see them. If they stop logging on, you don't. Dude, Atrioc, what is your title? Can you not read? If so, how did you write? Do you mean to read it to you? It says, it's been 10 years since Gangnam Style, but I never stopped dancing. No, that's not, it's all caps. Easy to read. Don't get it. Game audio very quiet. Nah, it's not. You're wrong. Hey, I have a oh shit. I saved it. I'm actually the fucking ghosty goat. I have a meeting with, I have a phone call with Spectrum tomorrow to hopefully, oh shit. Ah! No! I actually am the fucking clutchest clutch god of all time. To hopefully fix all the Fs that I'm getting. Ah! Damn the ghost, dude! Worst noise of the month. You keep track? I thought it was kind of cool. I mean, I'm just impressed because I don't play. You know, when the ghost is on screen, I'm not playing. I'm just watching. I get out a Ouija board and I let the seance happen and then he shows up. And sometimes he shows up to fucking play.
This is like a rice game experience? Yeah, similar.
Fuck! Those little headphone holders. I might do some other. I literally, legitimately, right after this game of Fall Guys, might do a crossword puzzle. I might just fucking whiplash everybody and no one will know what the fuck we're watching. I legitimately might do a crossword puzzle. Total Northern Lion moment. I saw one of his videos with it. I tried it. It was kind of fun. I legitimately might do it. Yeah, never let him know your next move. All right, where am I going? I'm going this way. Skroink. Oh, get up. That wasn't great. That was not great. Get up! Get up, Prince of Troy! Ah, shit balls. Oh, god damn it! Wait, get up! Oh, no! Wait, I'm not gonna qual. Everybody in this game, stop qualing! Stop qualing! Oh, I'm actually gonna lose. Wait. Oh, I'm actually gonna lose. Wait, unless I get up right now. Ah, stop! Everyone stop qualling! Stop it right now! Okay. Oh. Oh no. No! Stop qualling! <98. 2% like the milk, dude. Well, I guess we'll never know who wins the Ferrari. Yeah. Yikes. Crossword time? Any crossworders? Can we play another? No, we cannot play another. We're going to do crossword. All right? We cannot play another with the code EVRXI. Okay? We can't. We cannot do one more with EVRXI because that would be fucking ridiculous. I'm going to play Elden Ring 2, all right? Kind of relax. What is Lud messaging me? Lud messaged me a screenshot of my comment and said, am I just a farm to grab lulls from? Probably. Ah, I forget. No. Holy shit. Wait. Yeah, I told him skill issue, make better videos. I call him like I see him. Listen, even if I haven't watched it, if I say bad vid, sorry, bad vid. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Let's play one more. You should just cry on the floor for the rest of the stream. It would be real unique Mr. Beast type shit. I feel like Mr. Beast type shit is like I built Willy Wonka's chocolate factory, not I cried on the floor during a live stream for hours. I don't think that's... And then this guy says avant-garde, but spelled it wrong. yeah, I don't know, man. I don't know that you guys are the best advisors for me. You know what I'm saying? Maybe it's better if we keep our relationship strictly entertainment and not like you guys are my pseudo management team / viewership. We're the smartest poggies. Is that what I was? You think that was a takeaway? More like avant goat. Trust me, I learned from Gary Vee. That's how I know I'm backsliding. I watched I'm not kidding. I unironically, at about midnight last night, watched a Gary Vee video. Wait, what the fuck's happening with this? Yeah, I did. It was an interview. To be fair, with somebody I am more interested in, obviously, than Gary Vee, who's a fucking... Oh, no. Dude, what is going on? Why? The fucking... Wait, where are the things? The fucking... Those things. No, it wasn't an interview with Ben Shapiro. I'll see you at VCon next year, Drake. It was an interview with, not a great guy, but an interesting guy, Michael Ovitz. He was once the most powerful Hollywood agent. He kind of invented a lot of what's called packaging in the entertainment business, which kind of revolutionized it and took powers from the studios and gave it back to talent, which is pretty cool. Not Ari Gold. No. Michael Ovitz. He's an interesting guy, and it was an interesting, he taught actors how to pack. Yeah, his big innovation was like a roll of quarters in the fucking boxer briefs, dude. So it looked like you're fucking packing heat. Yeah, and that changed the game. That was really, it's why he's the greatest. I talk about his book. Yeah, I've read his book is the thing. I've read his book. And while he was like, he's just a very interesting, he had a very interesting life. Basically, he created CAA, which is the most powerful talent agency in history. They represented like Tom Cruise, Tom Hanks, every fucking, everybody, all the Toms, all the Chris's, Julia Roberts. They had every fucking major star. Oh, what the hell is this? And they were incredibly powerful. And then, And then at the height of his power, the CEO of Disney said, I want you to be my successor. Come to Disney and you can be president. And then when I retire, you'll be CEO. And he's like, okay. So he gets rid of all of his power. Like he just, he sells all of his shares of the most powerful talent agency ever, quits, goes to Disney. And the second he gets there, the CEO's kind of like, eh, nope. I'm not going to step down. And nobody there respects him or follows through on what he says. And within a year, they fire him. So he goes from being the most powerful person in Hollywood to completely out of the picture in like 2 years. Now, I'm not saying he got too screwed because he had a pretty good severance package. He made like 200, maybe even more. I think it was like $200 million golden parachute to get fired that early. But he could never regain like the power he had. So he was always like, he was like basically forced out of Hollywood. It's a very interesting story, his whole life. And his book was very interesting. And his former partner. So like, it was basically two guys that ran CAA, the biggest talent agency. It was him and his partner, Ron Meyer. They got into a huge fucking fight before he left. And he leaves to go to Disney, and his partner, Ron Meyer, leaves to go to Universal. And Ron Meyer is still the head of Universal, one of the most powerful people in Hollywood to this day. And Michael Woods has never been heard from again. So it's like he just, his whole fucking world collapsed. Oh, no. No, the AI! No! Not the fucking AI, dude. Oh, it's learning. It's learning. It's learning from my habits. It's analyzing my fears. Anyway, so I listened to an interview with him with Gary Vee. By the way, Gary Vee was a clown the whole interview. Kept talking over him. Kept saying stupid shit. Kept interrupting him. Kept asking dumb fucking questions. The guy was saying some real shit. And he was like, yeah, but what celebrity stories do you... It was like fucking... It was so whack. I hate Gary Vee, dude. He's a fucking clown. But the interview was good. And I did watch it. I have 100% watch time on a Gary Vee video. So I'm going to get... The fucking craziest recommendeds now. You see my strat here? I'm just the innovator. I'm the innovating goat. Stand in the middle and keep diving. They never get enough speed to knock you out. Who's Gary Vee? He's a real hustle porn kind of guy. Hustle, crush it, go big. You know, he's always like, he talks about NFTs, talks about crypto, talks about entrepreneurship, talks about being your own boss. CAA is Faker's agency? I mean, they represent a lot of people. CAA is up there with William Morris Endeavor as the two biggest agencies in the world. And for a while, like the 80s, 90s, there was nobody even close. They had like 75% of all big directors and actors and talent. And like you couldn't make a movie without them. And so they had incredible power. But basically they invented this concept called packaging, which is very interesting. Because before, like a movie studio, let's say you're Disney, right? You would have an idea for a movie. And then you'd go out to all the different actors and pick and choose who you wanted. So you'd be like, okay, we have a movie. Let's get this director. Let's get this actor for the lead role. Let's get a different actor for this role, and let's get this writer to help punch up the script or whatever. And what CAA would do is they would keep all of the ideas in-house, and they would pair up a director. They'd be like, all right, we got Steven Spielberg, and we're going to get Tom Cruise, and we're going to get... And they would just get a script writer, and they would make the whole movie already. They would get everything ready, and they would just go to the studio with everything already made. So they'd be like, Disney, you can either get all of these actors and this writer and this director for this movie called Ghostbusters, or you can get the fuck out. And the studios would be like... They would have way less power in the situation. They'd have to take it or miss the chance to get a great movie. So it turned the power. And then, like, it also meant that if you wanted to be part of these great movies, you had to be on CAA. Because, like, they were only doing deals as a package group with their whole people. And it just made them so much money, and it was just like a really smart business move. So unionization, sort of. I mean, it just flipped the leverage from the studios to the talent, which is like, yeah, it kind of is. It's similar to the process of a union where it's like you have the people basically refusing to work unless they all get paid the same higher wage. How long before that happens with streamers? It's kind of happening with the Cutie Cinderella effect. Basically, if you're not friends with Cutie Cinderella, there's a lot of shit you don't get invited to. She's kind of like the CIA of this time. You better be friends with the Cutie if you want to get invited to half the fucking shit that happens at Twitch. So, I'm staying in her good graces. Didn't it flip the power to the agency, not the talent? Well, the agency represented the talent, and they only made money when the talent made money. Agency makes 10% of whatever the talent makes. So, yes, it flipped the power to the agency, but it made the talent make a lot more money. Like, if you go back to the old days of Hollywood, the studio system, they would pay actors jack shit. They would sign them like 9 movie contracts, you know, their whole fucking career, and pay them nothing. And with CIA being so powerful, people got paid a fuck ton. I should keep track of what. Definitely this way, definitely this way. I'll lead. You guys just follow. You guys just follow because I got it all figured out. Legitimately though, this way. Okay. Dumb. Probably right here, dude. Yep. Everyone's just waiting. Oh, okay. All right. It's not there. It was probably there. Just go for it. Go for it, Kings. Oh, it's straight. It's straight. We know it's straight. Fuck it, I'll be brave. Okay. Okay, I think it's straight. Fuck it! Giga Chad! Giga fucking Chad! Giga fucking Chad! God damn, dude. Easily firsted? Oh, wait a minute, we got ourselves a final. The ghost in a final? Leaders lead, dude. Leaders lead. Mike Ovitz. One Mike Ovitz story that I am stealing from my regular life. Again, this is part of me backsliding. Mike Ovitz walked into a room. He said, I only want 15 minutes of your time. It was some actor or something he wanted to pitch. And like everyone says that. You know, everyone says that. He walked in. He took his watch off. Set it to 15 minutes. Put it on the table. Started talking. At exactly 15, he put the watch back on, shook the hand, and left. And the guy remembered it. The guy fucking remembered it. And he ended up signing with him. You know, because it's just sticking to your word. Oh, it's Hexagon? Wait a minute. You guys hear that? Feel a chill? Does anyone else feel a chill? A chill in the air? Oh no. Is that spirits? Is that a specter? What am I? What is that I'm feeling? What is that I'm feeling? What is that mysterious chill? Oh. Hello, bud. Hello, bud. You and me, bud. Uh-oh. Bro, this guy is a bit of a fuckwit. Uh-oh, bud. Oh, get up. Ooh, okay. Oh, there's a guy up there. Dude, okay, I have to clear out his fucking shit so he doesn't. Uh-oh. I'm getting cut off. Oh, yeah. You're not cutting me off, asshole. I do the cutting. Uh-huh. All right, it's me and this fuck. Oh, God damn it. What the hell do you think you're doing? Oh no. Oh no. Huh. Huh. Let's fucking go! God damn! That's the ghost! Did you see that gameplay? Oh my fucking God! He still got it! You put him on a classic hexagon. You put me on where my hours are? Whew, that was clean. That was just a clean gameplay. You give me talk about Mike Ovitz? I start grustling again, dude. Whew. Sheesh. One second. Snack. Love that song. Song bangs. Song bangs. One more? I don't mind one more. I can't. I'm gonna win. I'll do one more for the fans. Legitimately one more. I got my crown. You should end on a crown, but I'll do one more because I already got 60 people in here and I want to kick them out. We'll do legitimately one more and then I'm 100% out. I don't think I'm going to play Elden Ring, so I think I'll do a crossword or something else. Just Hadrian, thank you for the 4 months. Thanks for the sick content, always Big Ed. You've inspired me to pick up Hitman. Maybe I'll play Hitman. Wait, what if I play Hitman? What if I play, like, a random trending Hitman contract or something? That could be fun. That could be fun. That could be fun. I can't do Elden Ring because I don't have enough time. It's 10:10. It's 10:01. No. But you know what? I'm going to make a bold claim. I think I beat Elden Ring this week. Cap. Pepe laugh. No shot. Cap. Nope. Copium. Hopium. Joking. No shot. Never. You're not doing it. You guys are just all doubters and haters. Is there anyone out there who believes? Is there one? Is there no one else? Is there no one in the chat who's like, you know what? Maybe you can. Maybe I believe. Maybe Atrioc will get it this time. Who's going to stand up and be brave? Who's going to be that? Listen, the people who believe are the Spartans. And the people who doubt are the Xerxes army, the Persians. And just like in real life, the doubters will slaughter the believers. But it'll make a good story. Oh, Atrioc. Dude, the ghost is kind of on one. Can I say that? Is anyone else noticing that the ghost is kind of like just legitimately looking clean? Just overall, he's kind of like, he's got some bounce back in his step. Huh? The ghost watched a Gary Vee video and got him hyped. Dude, don't ever get the ghost hooked on Gary Vee. He starts grustling. I started playing Hitman after watching you play. Same with Teardown. I'm 40 hours in Hitman and 20 hours in Teardown. That's awesome. Those are both great games. I think if you like Hitman, low-key, secretly, you'll like Teardown. They seem very different, but they activate the same part of your brain. I would actually love to play Teardown again. I forgot. I never beat it, right? Wait, I never beat Teardown. In my mind, I beat it, but I never did. Wait, I should definitely play it. Teardown's so fucking fun. Yeah, I should finish the saga. Finish the fight. I got to beat Elden Ring, dude. The problem, my entire stream has frozen to a halt for the past month because of Elden Ring hanging over my head. I just need to beat it. I need to get in there and get the job done. And from there, I can... Dude, there's something about the ghost that just gives me the willies, dude. Gives me the heebie-jeebies. Just look how he fucking moves. Look at the lines he takes. It's uncanny. It's like watching a fucking fox hunt its prey. Like he's just always where he needs to be at the right time. Wait a minute. We have to kind of cut. Whoa. Don't try to. Okay. The ghost is a baddie. Listen, I've been saying it. Ghost is a bit of a baddie. Broke my collarbone, but used it as an excuse to buy Hitman. That's the Grussle in me, and I played 20 hours in a week. Okay. You don't probably need to break your collarbone as an excuse to buy a video game. That's probably not. I also broke my collarbone. I broke my collarbone. I have a similar sort of story where I went ATV riding. And I was up a hill, right? And there was like a trail on a hill. And the trail was out. I wish I could draw it for you. But I would lose this round. Let me see if I can get paint open real quick. Uh-oh. It's like, here's the mountain. And then it goes, it's winding up. And then right, it's out like that, like right there. It's out. So I'm riding up. And like, I'm like, okay, the trail is out. And imagine it's like kind of like this, right? I'm like, I'll just go around. So I just ride my ATV like kind of up the wall. I'm like trying to wall ride it over this. Oh, shit. And instead it just flips on its side and rolls down the hill with me on it. Breaks my collarbone. Thankfully, it didn't land on me or I would have broken a lot more. One of the dumbest things I've ever done. Wait a minute. Hold up. Oh, dude, what? This is a pushing Peter. He's a pushing Peter, but I'm back on track. Even if your life goes off track, you can get it back on track. Remember that. Life lessons from Fall Guys. Bro, the pushing Peter knocked me off, and I still have fucking 10-second time. Anyway, so yeah. So, I fall down. So I just tumble down the hill like this. I mean, it's probably lower down the hill, but I tumble down and there's like a bunch of rocks down here and I land on the rocks and then the ATV falls next to me and I'm fucking hurt to shit and my collarbone's broken. But because it's a collarbone, you don't know. Like, it's not like your arm where you can just tell. It's just a lot of pain, right? So I get up and I'm like, man, I feel like really bad. But my dad, who had taken me ATV riding, had promised to let me go to my friends that day where I was going to enter into a video game tournament at his house. And so I didn't want to not get to go to that because my dad would never let me compete from my own house. So I just told him that I felt fine because he was like, do we need to go to the hospital? I was like, no, I'm good. So I went, to this guy's house and I was trying to play a StarCraft tournament on his computer with a broken collarbone. And I remember thinking, man, I cannot move my fucking mouse. Like, it was like, I was in real pain trying to get that shit done. I did not win the tournament. I know the story would be great if I won the tournament. I did not. I did awfully. And I eventually felt so bad, like I couldn't sleep that night. So I called my dad. And I was like, hey, I need to go to the hospital. But I did lie about, oh, wait, is this, I'm not going to make it? I don't think I'm going to make it. Wait, the numbers aren't looking good here. Oh, no. Oh, baby. A triple. Wow. That is clutch. Oh, it was StarCraft. It was a StarCraft tournament. It was when I was first. I mean, this is like, I don't know, probably 17 at the time. So when I was first finding about Korean StarCraft, and there was a big non-Korean Team Liquid StarCraft tournament that I was entering, kind of just to show my skills. And I was really passionate about it at the time. And so, yeah, I lied. I lied to him. Tried to enter it. Fucking did terribly. Ooh, another final? Wait, hold up. Hold up. Wait a minute. This is truly my last game, though. May the best bean win. I played baseball with a majorly broken hand for 3 weeks. Your entire team hated you. The worst pitcher they've ever seen. Basically rolling the ball over to the plate. Never seen so many walks. How does this guy wear a crown? Wait, wearing a crown? Wait a minute, there's a crown? Wait, the ghost should wear a crown. That's the one accessory the ghost could wear. When did they add a crown accessory? Damn, how do you get that? That's so sick. It was a first anniversary item? Why wouldn't I have gotten it? I played since then. I played since launch. It was in the shop. You had to buy it. Kill me. God damn it. I'm gonna... They should legislate that. Fix loot boxes later. Fix me not getting anniversary items now. Okay? Let's solve the real problems first. Let's have a government for the people. I'll vote for Elon fucking Musk for president if he fucking gives me the Fall Guys crown. Oh, noe. Damn, boys, we jumping, huh? Jump, the house is jumping. Everyone's having a good time. Everyone's jumping. It's all fun and games. No fan either, so this is a real jump off. And we got two platforms to work with, so you know it's going to get sweaty. When it's a one platformer, sometimes you get to a no chance zone. Everybody's jumping for the weekend. Uh-oh. This could go to five. This could go to 5 minutes. We might have a fucking... Have to split the Ferrari five ways, boys. Four ways. Uh-oh. Three ways. Two ways. Hey, buddy. Hey, pal. Hey, friend. What's up? You want to split it or no? Because I could be persuaded either way. Put on a little pressure. Dude, fucking put on the song. Just put on the song. Ghost with the back-to-back, dude. What's the most you spent on a game and what game? Yeah, I spent a fucking rack on Counter-Strike Go, Punch. Why did I do that, Punch? Why did I spend a fucking rack on Counter-Strike Go? I don't even play that game. What a weird thing for me to do. No, probably League of Legends. I played League of Legends for years, dude. I was the most addicted college student in League of Legends. And I just dumped any money I had into that game to buy skins. Fuck. Just got a qual. Whoa. We're good. Oh! Nice. We're good. We're not doing Elden Ring tonight. No. Too late. I'm probably going to do the crossword, though, after this one. Are you going to restock the Enron hats? Yes. I know that I said I wouldn't before, but I talked to Aiden, and we can do it again, and we're going to do it because I've gotten so many requests. And also, when I was at Mogul Money Live, there was multiple people that had knockoff Enron hats that were like, bro, I couldn't find a real one. And I was like, all right, well, I guess I can't blame you. So, yeah, we'll bring it back. We're going to bring it back. I'm talking to Aiden. But Aiden's in Australia, so I have to be when he gets back. Yeah, Aiden went to Australia to hand-stitch the hats, okay? We have a factory there. He's working hard. Please, But what I want to try to do is make a different color. I was thinking like a mint green or... Not a mint green. A forest green. I think I want a forest green Enron hat. So I'm going to... We'll see. But I might get the classic tans as well. Crossword after this game? Yes, no matter what. Win or lose, I'm going to crossword after this game, I think. Yeah. I'll do one crossword. I already have a black, but I want a classic tan too. I think the tan is... It's fun because there's not many, I think, tan hats that I've ever really see nor like. And this one I always feel goes hard. I wear it a lot. I wear it too much, to be honest. Like, not even just on stream. Oi, oi, oi. Yeah, that's going to be an L. Maybe we can recover. Early start like that, though, is bad news, Broncos. Okay. We're actually regaining some ground. Okay, we're actually regaining some ground. We're good. We're Sedge. Does anyone still hold the Enron trademark? Nah. I mean, maybe a holding company, but they're not doing anything. They're not litigating. I have seen the Lily Looper speedrun, but it takes some real fucking risky dive cancels that if you mess up once, you're kind of out of the running. It would be fun to grind, but you'd have to set up a custom game with a bunch of other grinders that would agree not to finish the level and then just keep running it over and over, which I might do. Unironically, I might get fucking 10 grinders and get a custom game going and just fucking mash out Lily Leapers because it's fun to learn, but I'm not going to do it live. All right, last chance. This is for the crown. Let's see if the ghost can three-peat. Would be an insane three-peat. Focus! Oh, that's an L. Recover. Oh, it's an L. Sag. Yeah, that was fast. Didn't someone? Yeah, someone broke the record. Someone has a crazy one. You guys want to see it? Wait, I'll show you. Who had the link? I will show you. Listen, look, check this out. Dive. Bounce off the bottom. Dive. Dude, crisscross the whole thing. Oh my goodness. Yeah, it's fucking crazy. But beyond, I mean, I've tried this. The thing is, like, a lot, like right here, for example, you dive a little bit too high or too low, you fucking bonk, you're dead. I mean, it's, you know, it's, if you were racing someone, I don't know that you would do this. Even this guy, I think you would take a couple safer lines. But if you're just going for a speed run, obviously. Grass, find it. Hey man, if you're, listen, a lot of people are not touching grass. Not all people are doing that. If you're going to not touch grass, you might as well do that. You know what I'm saying? If you're going to, everyone's already sitting inside doing nothing, jerking off, wasting time. So if he's going to at least become a god at Little Ebers, this is cool. It's a cool clip. Okay. Here's what we are going to do. I am going to Alt F4 out of Fall Guys. Stick to my word, man of my word, and I'm going to try crossword puzzle. The problem is, okay, let's see. I think I have to go emote only. Emote only! Is there a mod? I'm going to be doing crossword puzzle. I'm going to put on a timer, and I'm going to see how long it takes me to beat this fucking thing. Where's my live split? Okay, here it is. Boom. Let's go! Timer. Okay. One across. Made do. Oh, country girls? Country girls do make do, but I don't think that fits here, so I'll come back to it. One down. World clock. STD. World clock shortened? Time zone, maybe? I don't know. So pretty. I don't know. Shit. Burritos wrap tortilla. Tortilla. Boom. That's got to help me out. So now I know that 17 across, snarky criticism about an Afghan. What the fuck does that mean? Snarky criticism about an Afghan? Like racism? Or like an Afghan, like... like the clothing aisle. What the fuck? All right. The bluest eye writer, Morrison. Toni Morrison. 18 down. Drink sample. Something I something. Drink sample. Sip. Easy. Okay. Give me four down. Four down is comes into one's own. Comes into your own. You've really come into your own. You've really grown. You've really matured. I don't know. Five. I'm so bored. Dude, I don't fucking know. I'm so bored. Four letters ends and end. Wait, what? I'm so bored. I don't know. All right. Try something else. So pretty could be like, aw. Aw, so pretty. Maybe. What about one down? World clock STD. STD means shortened, I assume. Otherwise, it's like, what do you mean? Like gonorrhea? World clock STD. World clock STD. World clock STD. A. Wait. What is that? What is the? I don't fucking know. God damn it. Money informally. Guap, dude. It's no. It's guap. It's fucking cheese. It's cheddar. It's green. It's cash. I don't. What is it? Money informally. Something something. Oh, something something. Damn, I'm getting fucking locked here. Dab with a napkin? All right, what's that? That's like to blot. Blot. Easy. Charitable giving. Charitable giving is... Babe.
What's that, Dom?
What is a five-letter word for I'm so bored that ends in N? Or what would you say when you're so bored?
Like I would say I'm bored. Wait, can I see?
Oh, wait.
Oh, I'm on camera.
There it is.
Wait, sorry, where?
It's right here. Five down. I'm so bored.
Down?
Ends in N. I'm so down, you think? No. What about a five-letter word for made do?
I hate crosswords. Made do? Like.
Yeah.
How about fuck you? Babe, I don't know. I'm here to get
Babe!
Babe! If it's not spelling me, I can't do it, okay? Why are you doing this? Why are you torturing yourself?
Babe, because it's fun, all right? I'm going to figure it out.
I'm literally not having fun.
Babe, what about a four-letter word for a wild guess?
How about a long-letter word for not fun? Crossword.
Damn, she doesn't miss! Wild guess? I'm going to say a shot. I'm going to say wild guess is... Oh, it's wrong. So I've decided every red letter I get, I'm going to gift one sub. So that counts as one. So it's not H. So I owe you guys one sub. Okay, 24 down. Wild guess. It's not a shot. But it is an S. A wild guess starts with S and it's not shot? Soup, dude. I don't fucking know. Oklahoma City with a Deco district. Who knows about cities in Oklahoma? Oh, Tulsa. Wait, Tulsa. Tulsa. Uh-oh. So a wild guess is like a stab. A stab! Oh, my God. He's breaking it. Wait, I need like, I don't know. Nailed a test. Aced. Aced. A-C-E-D. Aced it. Aced it. Japanese dog starts with A. Spamming a dog emoji does not help me. I know it already says dog. It's not a hint to say it's a dog. There's no help in that. You guys, there's no, I am benefited zero by you guys posting different pictures of dogs. Come back to that one. 49 down. Words on a sticker for the civically engaged. Bumper? Slogan. S-L-O-G-A-N. Fuck! 7. Bumper? 8! God damn it. Words on a sticker for the civically engaged. I don't know. Oh, I voted. Genius. Okay, we got there. Now, what kind of dog is this? Komodo dragon? Okay. Komodo. Akito? Akita? I feel like this is like a famous Japanese dog, but I don't know it. It sounds vaguely familiar, but I'm not Maybe if chat spam more dog emojis, it would help me out and I could figure out what this last letter is. Let's see if 31 down helps. This is cringeworthy. Awkward. Awkward. Nice. Okay, this is actually coming together. 61 across, polka dots. 68 across, brainstorm goal idea. 71 across, happiness director, salons. I'm going to assume it's Todd. Crushed it. I don't know you, Todd Salons. You're not famous enough to be in a crossword, brother. Okay. Herm. Wait, why is the... That's going. Wait, my fucking camera is covering the actual timer. Okay. We're getting there. I'm on record pace. 35 across. Curds and whey. Curds and whey. 27 down. Ha, right. Right. You beat the ghost in fall, guys. Yeah, right. I don't know. 28 down. Always sticking by. Loyalty. Oh, 9. Loyalty. What? Loyalty, right? What? Why would it not be a Y? Always stick it. Loyal to. Stupid fucking thing. It's not a word. It's two separate words. Loyalty be better. All right. 53 across. Tale about tucking someone in. Cover. Tale about tucking someone in. I don't know. Cover to cover? Cover story. Got it. 54 down is dinner rolls bread. No, S. I don't know. 63 across. False is about quilt. I never figured that out. 69. Search for treasure. Hunt. No. That doesn't count. Hunt. I know how to spell hunt. 72 across. Tablet in a modern classroom. I don't know. Tablet in a modern iPad? Easy clap. Oh, wow. Kids these days. You know, am I right? Screwed. What about the kids that bring Samsungs, by the way? Does every kid have to have a fucking goddamn $400 iPad to have a education nowadays? What if they have a fucking tablet? Or, God forbid, like a Google Nexus tablet or something. 37 across. EMT specialty. CPR. C. P. What? Oh, it was down. No. All right. Fine. Fucking 11. We're at 11. God damn it. CPR. They fucking tricked me. 37 across. Common game show prize. A car. A new car. Holy shit. Okay. A new car. 22 down. Mini albums briefly. What does that mean? Mini albums, but briefly. Oh, wait. This is across. EPs. I thought it was this long. Okay. 22 down is take the word of. I don't know what the fuck that means. Take the word of? 33 across. Make simpler. I don't know. 29 down. Root in a Cantonese cake. Taro root. Easy clap. 33 across. Make simpler. I do not know. Swear on. I swear on my... No, what? What? Take the word of I swear on my mother. I swear... Oh, that's so stupid. It must be... I guess Loro. I should have known his name isn't fucking Loro Lightfoot. Because that's a fucking fake superhero. That's not a mayor's name. No one would vote for Laurel Lightfoot. All right, your name is obviously Lori. God damn it. All right, so I'm at 13. 13. Trying to beat this under 30 minutes if I can. 33 across. Make simpler. I think it's something to do with easy, but I don't know. 13 down. Can I get that? Library storage areas. Shelves, right? Library storage areas are shelves. But that doesn't fit at all. Dude, I gotta blow my nose. Do I have a fucking napkin around here? Library storage area. No, and don't yep, and don't. No, I'd have to blow my nose, dude. 12, no, not sugar. What team building is meant to boost morale? It rarely does, but that's what it's supposed to do. Morale. You know what boosts team morale is not having to do stupid team building exercises. That's the best way to get morale up. Woolly animals that spit. Camels, right? No. Mammoths? No. Woolly animals that spit. How is it not a camel? All right, 10 down. Charitable giving is a... I don't know. Charitable giving? Oh, this is a cross. Sit-ups is abs. Abs. So what is this? What is charitable giving? Alms? Is it alms? Yeah, it is. I knew it. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. All right, 11 down. Llama. Llama. Wait, llamas. Ah, 13. Okay. 12 down. Library storage area. 19 across. Singer Baylor. I don't know. I don't know her name. Okay, what about this? 23 across. Cosmetics brand. MAC. Stacks. Holy shit. It's coming together. 9 down. Actor Jovan of Watchmen. I don't know. No way I'm going to know that. 6 across. Mother's Day VIP is moms, I assume. What? 14. Mother's Day VIP is not fucking... A la mode. Is it just mama? That's so stupid. Mother's Day VIP mama. Really fucking putting your degree to work, dictionary.com, fucking crossword writer. Really fucking making it happen. Thanks for really challenging me intellectually. 9 down. Jovan, I don't know your name, dude. Give me 15 across. Speed stat on the dash. MPH. If you're talking about America. Or kilometers, if you're talking about cringe. How do you fit cringe into Europe? uringe. 15. I'll work on it. Again, I'm using my lexicon brain for this. 15 across. Move tediously. Plod. What? This guy's name is Adpo? What fucking possible letter could go here to make a normal name? Adapo? Adipo? Adepo? What the hell is your name? Oh, okay, fine. 17 across. Snarky criticism about an Afghan. Something shade, I think. Shade. Adepo. Okay, it's something shade because it's criticism. It's something shade. An Afghan. I don't know. 5 down. I'm so bored. Dude, I can't figure it out. I'm so bored. I don't know. Made do. Oh, this the first part's the hardest. Comes into one own and has OMS. Groms. Bloms. Toms. Joms. Coms. Moms. Bombs. I don't know. I don't know. This one's fucking hard. Frad shade. I don't know, dude. Money informally. It's guap! I don't know. Money informally. What'd I say? It's yeah, I got some money. I got some green. I got some that fucking good. This is me trying to buy weed. I got some of that, you know, money? Me? Bro, I got some of that fucking, that shit. I got some of that, dude. You know me. Sheesh, dude. I'm getting paid, dude. I got some of that. World Clock STD. I don't know. T, it's not T. 14. GMT. Ah, that helps. That cracks the code. GMT, 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 GMT. One across. Made do. Made do. Made do. This is a big fucking moolah. Moolah. Wow, that's so fucking dated. Whoever wrote this. Ooh, that's good. Moolah. That's a big code cracker. I'm so bored. I don't know that one still. I don't know this one. Four down. Comes into one zone. Glow up? I don't know, dude. What the hell? I'm still a little lost. So pretty. What if it's... Ooh. Oh, it's H. 19. Ooh, so pretty. Oh, throw shade. Throw shade is... That's not about an Afghan. They said about anything or anyone. Wait, what? Throw shade? How is that about an Afghan? I don't get that clue at all. There's something there I'm not getting. Made do. Got it? Got it? Illumes? Blooms. Blooms! Got by. Got by! Yes! Oh my god, I'm clutching it. Wait. 58 across. Expected. I don't know. 54 down. Dinner rolls. Sushi! Sushi! Oh my god. 50 down. Meet the moment. Sst. Expected. Expected. Do? Do. Okay. Stellup? Stenup? Steckup? I don't know. 50 down. Meet the moment. Step up. Step up. Like the movie. They should have said great movie about dancers in the streets of Harlem. 63 across. Falsehoods about quilts. I don't know. Spin a lie. Spin? No. 20. I don't know. 64 down. Protein synthesis mark. DNA. What? It's not DNA? 21. RNA. Okay. Spur. Falsehoods about 60 down. Make or break time. I don't know. 60 down. Dear sacred. Ah! We don't get there in time. Oh my god, wait. So for some reason the timer paused. 67 across. First roomie, maybe. I don't know. 60. Oh god, we're so close, and the timer's right there. We only have 15 seconds left. Ah! Oh, we're so close. What could it be? 65 down. Takeoff guess. Abbreviated. Takeoff. Takeoff guess. Takeoff guess. Falsehoods about quills. ETD. Oh. Spread. Lies. Oh, yeah, baby. And the clock is ticking. And we're almost there, though. Oh, my God. We're getting close. It's make or break time. Dear sacred elk. Elk! Holy shit. 67 down. First roomie, maybe. I don't fucking know. 73 across. Pulls hard. Yanks. My first roomie was sus? Is that what you're saying? 67 down. First roomie, maybe. Sass? Sis? Sis! Oh, you're sis! And now... garlicky mayo aioli make or break time. Wait, fuck. Shit. Oh, we don't have, we're out of time. Oh, what could this last one be? It is truly make or break time. Ah, I can't figure it out. There's like 5 seconds left. I need to clutch it. It's gotta be D-Day! Yeah! Yeah, wait a minute. I would have got it in 30 if I just... My timer was wrong. Yeah! My streamer! Holy shit, he did it! Let's go! World record! You said 13 like three times. All right, well, what was the total? You guys think it was like 8? We'll round it out to an even 8. I also jumped up at one point, though. I know for a fact I jumped up on one of them. We'll call it an even 20 subs. 22, if you must, on one of them. All right, let's get the sub. Who's going to get the free 20 subs in chat? That's a 22 subs is a good amount of money. Wait a minute. All right, we'll start with 20. No, wait. We'll start with 20. Here it is. Ba-ding, ba-ding, ba-ding. Who's getting it? Wow. Retro Grays, Jay Jameson, It Mival, Governor Llama, Envies, Emperor, Jedi Sammy, Maynard Ferguson, welcome all, welcome one and all, God's Boy, Low Snivy, welcome to the Atrioc Army, welcome to the fam, dude. I'm going to give you 2 more subs, actually. This is a special sub. Came to Tukar the Power, and then finally, one more sub. Uh-oh, a chance to have the greatest salute emote in the game on all of Twitch. A chance to have whale. A chance to have nine head. Let's see. It goes to Things Go Boom 27. Congrats. Speaking of sevens, can I see some goddamn sevens at the end of the stream tonight? I hope you enjoyed. I would love to see some sevens. That was a fun stream. We did a lot of different random shit, but I had a good time. Start to finish, straight up. That was fun. Sevens. I'll be back tomorrow. Tomorrow's Friday. I'm going to do Reddit recap and Elden Ring. Hopefully trying to finish it by the weekend so I can play Ori as soon as possible. And also I need to get ready because we are only T-minus 12 days from a brand new Hitman map. And I'm going to go fucking crazy on that. So let's see here. I think I would happily raid. I guess Evan Gao would be fun to raid. Yeah, I guess you guys can go watch my pal Evan Gao. Evan Gao. Actually, I'll read Evan. I should read Cutie, though. The thing is, Cutie is going to be making a wedding cake for my wedding for free. A really fucking nice one. And I'll read her next time. I'll read Evan Gao because I already said it. But if you do end up going to Kudu stream, say hi. Bye. Bye. Sevens, bye, 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 bye. Have a good night. Have fun. Seriously. I semi-mean it, even though I don't know you. And I won't really care once I hit this button. But before I hit the button, I do care. And I hope you have a good day. Bye.